Let's look at the answer for our hit time quiz. In a well-designed cache, hit time is significantly lower than miss time. Miss time includes the hit time and the miss penalty. Typically, we want the hit time to be very small, and that means that the miss time should not be anywhere close to the hit time. And if there is any miss penalty, miss time will be larger than hit time anyway. So this should be true for every cache, even if you didn't design it very well. Hit time is larger than the miss penalty. We definitely don't want that. The miss penalty is the memory access time. If our hit time is similar to that, or larger than that, then the cache is not going to be useful at all. So this should not be selected. Hit time equals to the miss penalty? No, we want the hit time to be significantly less than the miss penalty. If it is equal to the miss penalty, we might just as well go to memory every time, because that's what the miss penalty is about. So we should not select this. And finally, miss time larger than the miss penalty. Miss time is equal to the hit time plus the miss penalty, which means that the miss time should always be larger than the miss penalty anyway. So this is true for every cache, not only a well-designed one. As we can see, for a cache to be beneficial, it needs to have a low hit time. In fact, in a well-designed cache, we can say that the hit time is much less than miss time, while the miss time and miss penalty should be similar to each other because the hit time is so small, and the difference between the two is the hit time.